Selena.
Thanks, Vanessa. We undertake you live to Canberra in a news conference with opposition frontbencher Eric Abetz. He'll be responding to Senate committee admissions by Fair Work Australia that the Thomson inquiry is taking an unreasonably long time. Here's Eric Abetz.
An institutional go slow. Further, we had Minister Shorten trying to claim that this evidence of emails was old news, benign news, and was of no consequence. Well, today we have learnt that there was in fact at least three more contacts with ministers' offices and Fair Work Australia, and we've also learnt that there was contact by Minister Shorten's office with Fair Work Australia at the time he was saying this, and of course Minister Evans' office staffer knew that the answer that was tabled in the Senate was incomplete, but no action was taken to correct that. I'll now pass to Senator Ronaldson.
Thank you, Eric. Well, look, last night we had the remarkable revelation that Mr. Pirani from the AEC, the Chief Legal Advisor, had been told in February of last year by one of the senior investigators that the report was almost finalised. Today we had Mr. Nassios agreeing that the report. Neither Mr. Nassios nor Ms. O'Neill confirmed or denied whether Mr. Craig Thomson had been served with notices in relation to possible contravention. Here was the opportunity to let Mr. Thomson off the hook and confirm his allegation that he hadn't been served with these papers. Their refusal to do so, I think, leaves this question very much unanswered, and 2 and 2 still equals 4.
Senator,
any questions?
What's your understanding of the publication of the final report? Do you think it should be done, and do you accept their reasons that for legal reasons, defamation reasons and so on, that it shouldn't be made public?
The final report should be made available given the lengthy delays that we've experienced. Indeed, Fair Work Australia today were reduced to acknowledging that they were unreasonable delays. Given that, I think the Australian public are entitled to the report, and if there are certain matters that do need to be redacted from it because of legal matters, so be it. But I think as much of it as possible should be made available to the public.
Would it be appropriate for the Prime Minister to table that, or who would table it, the Workplace Minister?
Well, whoever the Prime Minister might be at the time, we don't know, but the person who currently holds the office of Prime Minister in fact set up this farce, which is Fair Work Australia, and was responsible for the appointment of the personnel into Fair Work Australia, so let's not forget that. But having said that, I believe that the Minister should seek, without interfering in the process, ensure that there is openness and transparency, and in fact that is something we were promised by both Mr. Rudd and Ms. Gillard, so irrespective of who might be Prime Minister tomorrow, they should live up to those promises.
Can I just say in relation to the Ms. O'Neill's comment about defamation proceedings, that is the only reason that has now been given for these reports not to be released. Not because of the investigation still going on, it's because Ms. O'Neill might be sued for defamation. Now, Ms. O'Neill should be told by this afternoon that indeed if the Senate committee requests that report, then there is no, of course, defamation proceedings. If it comes out through FAI, again, she will not be open. So, look, this is just another excuse and another reason to delay the public knowing what they should know about what Mr. Thomson's involvement was and what the outcome of the investigation is.
Ms. O'Neill announced a review today into the investigation. Are you happy with that, or are you concerned that that might actually delay the report's coming out once again?
Let's just hope that the review into the inquiry and investigation doesn't take as long as the investigation itself. At least Fair Work Australia have finally come to the position where they've acknowledged there are unreasonable delays on the face of it. Before today, that was constantly being denied by both the Minister and Fair Work Australia. That is now acknowledged, and having a review, I think, will tell them what they should know instinctively.
The Prime Minister and Mr. Shorten should direct Fair Work Australia to put a time frame on that review. It is totally unacceptable for Ms. O'Neill not to be able to tell the Senate today what time frame she's given KPMG to provide her with this review. She said there was a scoping study for a week. She must insist on them giving her a time frame. And if they won't, the Prime Minister, who has been defending Mr. Thomson for the last 3 years, must demand that there be a time frame from KPMG. Either she or Mr. Shorten have got to get involved at least in that aspect of this inquiry.
Senator Abetz, do you accept Bernadette O'Neill's...
Senator Michael Rollinson there speaking alongside Eric Abetz, and you can continue to watch that news conference. Just press red on your remote and go to Sky News Multiview. Let's speak to Sky News political reporter.